Hi everyone, in this video I'm going to show you how to create footnotes and endnotes in Microsoft Word. You'll learn how to insert, customize, convert, and delete your footnotes and endnotes. If you want to follow along with me with this video, I'll include a link in the description below and you can download the sample copy of the document that we use today. Let's get started. Footnotes and endnotes are useful in adding references to your document without cluttering up the main text in your document. So I've outlined here in green a couple areas where I want to add footnotes in my document, and there's a few areas in blue where I'm going to add endnotes. So I'm going to zoom in so you can see this a little bit better. And the first thing we're going to do is place our cursor exactly where we want to insert the first footnote. So then we go up to the References tab on your ribbon, and in the Footnotes area, just click on Insert Footnote. Now notice if we scroll back up, it insert a superscript 1, and then down at the bottom, it created a section at the bottom of the page to add your footnote. So the cursor is down here now, and now I can type out my footnote. All right, I'm going to scroll back up and just place my cursor at the next area where I want to insert my next footnote, and then go up and click on Insert Footnote, and that adds footnote number 2. Now I'm going to add several more of these just so that you will be able to see how we can convert and delete these at the end. But I'm just going to scroll back up in my document, and everywhere where I have a green reference point, I'm going to insert a footnote. And we've got one right here. We'll insert a footnote there. That's our number 4. And one last one right here for our footnote number 5. And just click on Insert Footnote. And now I have a couple areas where we want to add endnotes. So place our cursor there. And instead of inserting a footnote, just click on Insert Endnote. And now what that does is it adds a section for endnotes at the very bottom of the document. So at the last page of the document, it will add that section and you can insert your endnote there. And let's do one more, and we're going to insert that endnote. So now that we have our footnotes and endnotes inserted into our document, let's say we want to change the formatting. So instead of numbers with Roman numerals for the endnotes, let's say we want to use letters. So I'm just going to come up and click on this down arrow that's in the bottom of the ribbon where it says footnotes, and this will open up a pop-up window where we can edit our footnotes and endnotes. So click on footnotes. And we have different options here. You can include them on the bottom of the page or below text. If you want to, we can come down to the number format area, drop down, and let's select letters instead. We'll select capital letters for our footnotes. And then what we can do is say we want to apply this to the whole document and click apply. And so now instead of numbers, our footnotes up here are letters instead. And so likewise, if we wanted to edit our endnotes, we can come up and pop out that edit window, select the endnotes, and then we can drop down and say we want lowercase letters for the endnotes, and then apply that to the document. Now, another thing we can do is we can convert. If we decide we want all endnotes instead of footnotes, we can convert that. So if we go back up to our customized pop-up and click on this button that says Convert, and we have three different options. So you can convert all footnotes to endnotes, you can convert all endnotes to footnotes, or you can swap them. So I'm going to convert all my footnotes to endnotes, so we'll just have everything at the end of the document. And I'm going to click OK. And we'll insert that. So now notice it removed the footnotes from the bottom of the document and placed everything down here in the endnote section. And if there are any errors or issues, so I noticed it added an extra thing where my cursor was, I'm going to go ahead and delete that. We'll hit backspace delete, and it automatically fixes the numbering that's down there on your endnotes. So one thing we also want to do is, let's say we need to delete an item. So if we want to delete, let's say, the last footnote here, all I have to do is place my cursor next to the subscript, and I'm going to hit backspace. It'll select that superscript, and then I'm going to hit backspace again to delete it. And notice that it removes that from the list of endnotes at the bottom of the page. But let's say that we come up here and we have one of these items up here that we want to, that's in the middle. So let's, if this is E, down here, E is footnote text 5, right? So let's go ahead and place our cursor right next to the subscript and hit backspace to select it and delete that. It automatically deletes that from the endnotes, but it doesn't necessarily renumber or reorder the endnotes or footnotes that are within your document. So to do that, what we want to do is come back up to the pop-up and simply go ahead and reselect your option here for the number format that you want and click apply. And then that will renumber the any following endnotes or footnotes that come after that in your document. So everything will be aligned with the numbering at the end of your document if you have to delete anything. Now, one more thing I want to show you how to do is you can navigate to the footnotes throughout your document. If you have your cursor placed at one of them and you want to jump to the next one, since these are endnotes, what we're going to do is drop down instead of saying next footnote, we're going to say next endnote, and it will jump to our cursor will be at the next endnote and or footnote if you need to navigate to the next footnote in your document. So now you know how to customize and edit your footnotes and endnotes in Microsoft Word. I hope you found this video helpful. Be sure and give it a thumbs up to like it and share it with your friends and colleagues who may also find it helpful. Visit my website, SharonSmithHR.com. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.